And today you talk about BioPatty, a new probiotic developed to help honeybees. Stay tuned. Welcome to InsideTheHive.tv, the show that takes you into the world of bees. I'm your host, Umberto Boncrociani. If you like bees and want to know more about them, please consider to subscribe and also hit the bell button so you don't miss a single video. BioPatty, a new probiotic, got a lot of attention in 2018. And even winning an honorable mention on Times Magazine as the Invention of the Year contest. It's very exciting. It's very promising. The idea is interesting. I'm not sure how those competition works, this contest of Times Magazine, if they need to provide data or to show if the product works or not, or it's just about the potential of the project. It is very interesting, no doubt about it. They just released a new paper a couple months ago, and a lot of beekeepers asking my opinion about the article. Before I go into the experiments, I would like to invite the authors if they feel that my interpretation, my thoughts on these articles are not accurate. They are invited to come here. We do another video to clarify things. I'll be very glad to have the authors in the show to discuss this promising and very exciting research. The promising patty came back to the news because of the release of the scientific article claiming that the patty, the probiotic delivering this protein patty, can help with one of the most devastating honeybee diseases, American foulbrood. If you're new to bees, American foulbrood is the most devastating disease of honeybees so far. It's caused by a spore-forming bacteria called Penicillium larvae, and it's the most widespread and destructive bee disease ever documented. Because it can persist in nature for 40 years, in many different places on the planet, it is the law to destroy the honeybee hive when the infection is confirmed. And so in many instances, the beekeeper need to burn the whole beehive, all the equipment, all the bees, to get rid of that disease. That's the law in many places. The article is entitled Novel Probiotic Approach to Counter Penicillium Larvae Infections in Honeybees. It was published in the Multidisciplinary Journal of Microbial Ecology and is led by Brandon Desley, and the corresponding author is the famous Dr. Gregor Reed. Both belong to the Department of Microbiology and Immunology, the University of Western Ontario in Canada. And for transparency here, I need also to mention that both of them are part of the scientific committee of SEED, the company behind the production and the distribution of this patty. And the reason I mention that is because the authors declare no conflict of interest. And that was weird to me. I don't know if there is any reason that I'm missing here, but for me, this sound, I think it's a mistake, because the group is very serious people. I'm completely in favor of this kind of research. This is very exciting. There is a lot of evidences out there that the microflora can have health benefits in humans and other animals, and why not in honeybees? There are a lot of discussions and some evidences already in honeybees as well. The idea is very attractive to me for one reason, because the possibility to eliminate antibiotic use that could contaminate honey, and there is a lot of issues that come together when people need to use antibiotics in honeybee hives. So if there is anything out there that can eliminate the use of antibiotics, I'm completely in. I encourage everyone to read the article. It's available to everybody. I will leave a link in the description below. The authors perform a field trial, or a sort of a field trial, to try to understand the effect of the addition of certain bacteria in a diet of honeybees. And then they want to know the overall health of honeybees when they are infected with the American foulbrood. The authors were very smart and they took advantage of a natural outbreak of American foulbrood. What I couldn't understand is the timeline of the events. I didn't know, for example, if they knew beforehand in that bee yard they have American foulbrood in it and they performed the experiment knowing they have it, or if they're testing for something else and they got American foulbrood in the middle and they need to rearrange to perform the experiment. So I'm not sure how the experiment was done, so I'm not going into many details here. It's not an easy thing, I just want to mention, it's not easy to work with bees in field trials. It's one of the most difficult things that we have is to work with honeybees in field trial. There were three groups in this study. The group number one that received no supplementation at all. There is a group number two that receive a protein patty control with no probiotics in it. And a group number three that received the full patty with the probiotics in it. It was only two honeybee hives per group, which is a very low sample size to call it a field trial in my opinion. But sometimes we have to work with what we have, and that's the way research works sometimes. You can find the patty ingredients right here. The supplementation schedule was bees were fed on day 0 and day 7 of the field trial. Sampling. Adult nursery bees were sampled 30 bees each on day 0 and after the end of the experiment on the day 12. Larvae samples they only have on day 12. I'm not sure the reason for that, but they only collect larvae on day 12. There is no information about the total number of bees. There is no information about the brood patterns and other diseases in those hives. We don't have information about mites. We don't have information about the consumptions of the patties. So we don't understand how the overall health of the beehives were at the time. In figure 1A, the authors show a gel electrophoresis, a DNA electrophoresis, just to confirm the subtype of the bacteria, the American foulbrood bacteria they were working on. I'm not going into details of that. If you want to go into details of the article and have questions for me, things that are more technical, please consider to support me on patreon.com/insidethehivetv. So there you know more how you can support this channel and this kind of content. And I appreciate, thank you for your support. On figure 1B, you can see the honeybee larvae from colonies fed with the BioPatty have a significantly lower level of American foulbrood compared with no supplementation or with the patties without the probiotics in it. It's very important to mention here that we don't have a baseline to compare. We don't have what happened on day 0. We don't know the levels of infections in the larvae on day 0. This is a snapshot of whatever happened on day 12 in that bee yard. And any beekeeper that I know understands that in a bee yard that have 20 to 50 honeybee hives, there is so much variables regarding diseases, especially American foulbrood, even with American foulbrood. In a bee yard, we have a couple of hives that might be really sick and the other are thriving, and we don't have explanation for. A few trials, research with honeybees is a very difficult thing to do, and I would not be comfortable with the result the way it is with the limited sample size that we have. The sun came out. Finally, I can walk. So, as you can see on a figure 1C, there was an elevation of bacteria activity. Only in the group that received protein patties without the probiotics in it. If you look at the two other groups that received no feeding, or the group that received the BioPatty with the probiotics in it, there was no elevation of bacteria activity. Not much. And when you look at the kind of bacteria that was elevated in that group, there was proteobacteria, alpha, beta, and gamma. You can see here in a figure 1D. And those bacteria, for some authors, they're considered not very good bacteria. This is debatable, but that's the result they got. The only bacteria that grow in a group that received the full BioPatty with the probiotics in it are bacteria from the phylum Actinobacteria, and of course the Lactobacillus plantarum, Lactobacillus rhamnosus, and Lactobacillus conchis, which are the bacteria in the BioPatty. So these are the probiotics itself. A couple of important things to discuss here. One, the bacteria, when they're consumed by the honeybees, they're able to establish themselves. Second thing is that when they establish themselves, apparently they do not allow other bacteria to grow. So there is some competition there going on that do not allow other bacteria to grow. The authors even suggest one step further that maybe there is some compositions of protein patties that might stimulate the growth of bacteria and start hurting the bees. So are protein patties able to hurt bees? Maybe. I'm sure there is lots of things to consider here before I start to make any claims. The kind of protein patties, the compositions, what they have in those protein patties, all those things count. Very interesting concept. When you look in the literature, there are a couple of studies showing beneficial effects of protein patties. Another study showing that protein patties do not have any beneficial for honeybees at all. So let's keep that in mind. Maybe there is a possibility that protein patties might hurt honeybees. In conclusion, regarding the field trial, when you get all those results together in the way and the conditions the experiments were done, if I need to give my personal opinion, I like the indication that we have, but I will be very skeptical to believe the results with the sample size that we get. I need to be very clear with that. Field trials with honeybees are really difficult. We cannot control the variables when the bees are outside. That's why when we work with field trials, my minimal number is 30 bees per group, 30 hives per group or more, to start to get some statistical power. But again, there is indication there, and when we have indications in field trials, we should be celebrating. And I'm very happy for the authors to have the results they got. And we should follow up on that, and should follow up and research. That kind of research need to be funded even more. However, things get much more interesting when the authors bring experiments to the laboratory where they can control the variables a little bit more. And if you want to know the results of the laboratory experiments, please click this video right here, so you can follow up about the research conducted by this author. Please consider to click the logo here to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any other video that I upload. Thanks for watching Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.